I'm Elaine Cirlino. I'm a correspondent with the New York Times in Paris and former bureau chief. And I'm sitting here in Washington in Georgetown because I'm in the U.S. talking about my book, La Seduction, How the French Play the Game of Life. It is a book that was born of serendipity. In 2008, I had to give a speech at the New York Public Library about France, and President Sarkozy had just been in office for 1 year. He had just married Carla Bruni, the former model, and I didn't want to bore my audience by telling them about French troops in Afghanistan or why France was returning to the military wing of NATO, so I spun a whole speech around the thesis that the key to understanding France is seduction in all aspects, from the bedroom to the boardroom, from history to politics, from food to perfume, from manners to culture. And Paul Gallup, who had been the editor on my last book, which was about Iran, came up to me afterwards and he said, Elaine, this is your next book. So I embarked on a project that took me off for almost 2 years, and the book was published a couple of months ago. And it's currently being translated into French. So I thought I'd come to Washington and also to New York and visiting a few other places, both to promote the book. In addition, the French ambassador here honored me with a wonderful reception because in June I was decorated with the Legion of Honor, which was a great, great honor for me, you know, coming from a small, modest family in Buffalo, New York. And I lived in Washington for many years. I was the diplomatic correspondent and the CIA correspondent for the New York Times. And I even found seduction in diplomacy because I found that, you know, what is diplomacy if not a seduction that doesn't end? Diplomacy is keeping countries out of war, so it's all about trying to talk your way out of a difficult situation and talk your way out of using force when words might do. You know, people ask me all the time, okay, Lane, isn't it a bit over the top to say seduction is the driving force or the motor for all of French life? And I don't think it's that much of a stretch, because the French, unlike Americans, are into process. They're into prolonging the pleasure, whether it's the pleasure of a meal and needing to think about what you're going to cook that day, and then going out and buying everything, and then cooking it, and then talking about it afterwards. The eating of the meal sometimes is the least important component. In a sense, it's the same with sex, and my chapter on sex is called It's Not About the Sex, because so much of what the French do is anticipation of the sex act and memory of the sex act. How many times have you seen people in subways or on bridges in Paris just kissing interminably? And I would argue that if they were American, they already would have taken it into the bedroom. You know, we remember Georges Clemenceau as the prime minister who tried to resolve the aftermath of World War I, but he also was a novelist, and there's a character in one of his novels who says, the most wonderful moment in love is when I climb the stairs. And it's that notion of the anticipation and the process that I think drives seduction. I mean, seduction is also a word that is used very differently from the way we use it in the United States, where we might use the word charm or attract or persuade. The French will use the word seduce. I even set up a Google alert and found in the course of 3 months hundreds and hundreds of uses of the word seduction and seduce in the oddest places. I mean, for example, the Pope was seducing the Palestinians by calling for a Palestinian state, or the French strategy in Afghanistan was an opération séduction, an operation seduction. We had the milk processors of Lille seducing their customers. So it's a different kind of approach from our sometimes humdrum, goal-driven kinds of society. I mean, I sometimes say that, you know, the French hero is someone like D'Artagnan of the Three Musketeers, who was a master fencer, and it was all about the elegance of the movements. Where in America, one of our iconic heroes is Gary Cooper in High Noon, and who when he shot to kill. It was to go right to the goal. So this is what drove me and motivated me to write this book. Now that I'm on the other side of it, I can enjoy what was an interesting process and take pleasure in the fact that I'm here talking to people like you about it.